Hello everyone. We have Mr. Amit Tiwari, Vice President Marketing, Havells with us here. Thank you very much for joining us. So the context of this conversation is how non-metros are driving the next phase of growth in the country, and how is the consumer durable category adopting to these changes, and where the focus now stays as far as non-metros leading the economic resurgence is concerned. So we'd like to know from you, Mr. Tiwari, how has these last 6 months been for Havells as a consumer durable, brand, and what are some of the key learnings during the period?
So thank you, Dipali. Thank you for hosting me. I think it's a wonderful platform to be to share my particular learning, specifically when it comes to non-metro, which most of the people, and we also believe that it's the real Bharat, and that is where the entire growth will actually to look for. So before we get into how it has been for last 6 months, I think if you see for last 5 years data, 2015 to 2019, 2020 data is yet to come. Metros have grown on an average of from 25 to 28%, whereas if you see the non-metros, they've already reached around 45%, close to. So what has happened is now the entire trajectory of growth has actually changed from metros to non-metros, because that is where the entire particular appetite is happening. Now the bigger question is, what exactly it is the growth that is coming? Is it only to durables? It is only to every sector you talk about. You talk about apparels, it is growing faster in non-metros. You talk about automobile, it is growing faster in non-metros. If you talk about mobile phones, if you talk about white goods, if you talk about durables, kitchen appliances, everything is growing and exponentially high when it comes to non-metros to look for. Is it something that has happened over 6 months? Or no, it has not happened over 6 months or something as to look for. It has happened beyond. Why it has happened is because entire electrification of India, if you compare between 2015 and 2020 today, that is what a rampant pace in terms of the way it has actually moved. Today, the quality of electricity, the quality of power that you get is much, much better. The propensity of people to spend on those markets are very high. But what were the drawback? That most of the brands were not reaching to those markets. Why they were not reaching to those particular markets in totalities is because people were not thinking that the propensity to spend will be higher. Will they be spending for a, let's say, 75-inch television? Will they spend on a 65-inch television? Why will they not? They have all the whereabouts. Now they have electricity. They have the entire particular connection in terms of Wi-Fi. The entire internet penetration has also grown high. And thanks to Jio and other particular mobile data providers who have actually been concentrating across these Bharat markets to bring it across. What has happened in last 6 months is the COVID situation has actually given a catalyst to all these markets, because the impact of COVID was quite less. The all of your with your lockdown, unlock and everything, these guys were least affected in the entire process to look for. So their entire particular revamping becomes much faster. The rebounding becomes much, much faster in the entire space. Due to which what has happened is they have started showing progress and they have started showing signs much better than as compared to metros today.
Right. So if there, in terms of, if we look at the consumer behavioral changes, in terms of product categories, have you noticed, say, are they going for semi-premium or are they going for a premium brand, or what's the kind of demarcation in the category?
See, the bigger thing where they're actually looking for it is, it can be classified under three A's. They're actually looking for something which is affordable, and it is not affordable by price. It is affordable by their particular needs. And what does that actually mean? So for example, if somebody has a family of 7 or 8 people, is this particular product is affordable to serve to my particular entire family? Second thing, which is also very important, is authenticity. What happens is most of the people, if you see, think that they will do some particular changes in their particular P2 or P3 market used to call 5 years, 7 years back. Is the product real authentic? And the third thing, which is more, valuable input, which goes from the entire three A's to talk about is action. Is there a nearby store where I can actually buy, or is it the online fulfilling my demand? How is the entire particular piece moving in the entire ecosystem? And because of that, see, it's not a, even if people say it's a price conscious market. No, it's not a price conscious market. They're a value seeking market. If I'm spending something, am I getting the value for my family and for myself, whatever it is, and any category that need to look for? And that is why if you see most of your entire e-commerce platform, the amount of searches that has emerged in last 4 or 5 months, the amount of searches that has come from all these non-metro market has increased to 2x. It has increased to 2x across category. I can name the categories you talk about, whether it is automobile, whether it is digital services, whether it is online learning, white goods, consumer goods, entertainment. It has gone to that level today. So it is nothing to do with premium or not premium. Is this particular product serving my need? I am ready to pay extra. I am ready to shell out extra. I am ready to do an extra mile to get this particular product in my particular portfolio of household that I have.
Okay. So you mean even online sale also increased during this lockdown?
See, online has actually increased, and online has actually done a very, very different job in the entire market. So, see, distribution is a costly business. If you actually see putting up a shop, doing a particular running a particular shop or a showroom or your brand store, it's a costly proposition. What has done these particular two platforms, all your platforms, what they have done is, first is the education. How would I come to know about my particular product? What does people think about my product? So your ratings and reviews and everything, you get it on these platforms, you know, and you're also fulfilling. So today, let's say I decided I stay somewhere in the outskirts of, let's say, Ranchi or Patna or somewhere, and I have a desire for a headphone. And when I went to it, I found that, okay, Bose is the best headphone that can actually be suffice for this particular what people are talking about, the selection of product which I had done, how people look. So I am also getting educated that it's a noiseless thing. Will Bose able to set up a store near Ranchi or something else? It will never do. Either you would be sold in a large format retail, or either you'll sell it in a large or a regional retail store, but not your own particular store. How I can do it? I am getting education. My entire particular fulfillment is happening from there. And I'm also trying to build this entire particular ecosystem. That's how it is.
Great. And even touch and feel and demonstration also becomes important on physical stores, right? And that becomes a critical part of the ecosystem. So how are you addressing this in the non-metros?
See, there are a lot of regional retails that have already been placed, which are confined to their different geographies to actually talk about. So every regional store has their own strength across the entire spectrum of India that you talk about. So people definitely want to have a touch and a feel to look. But if you see one thing, Dipali, in last 5 to 6 months, one thing has also changed from a consumer behavior standpoint is nobody really wants to touch a product today. Because that's the biggest difference that a consumer really wants to do it. And if you have noticed in last 4 or 5 months, right from a plywood manufacturer to a garment manufacturer to, let's say, a soap manufacturer to your upholstery manufacturers, everybody is talking about antivirus promotion, that is antivirus laminates, antivirus your clothing, antivirus your stitching material, clothing material, everything is talking on that direction. Why they're actually trying to do? Because end of the day, if you want to buy a cloth, you definitely want to see what's the texture and how does the feel of that. But today, really, people for a goods and specifically for a product that you really want to buy, nobody wants to touch it. People say, I will only touch it when I am satisfied with all the sanitation that I can actually do for in the entire space. So that's a shift that is happening across. It is not about only metros, non-metros, anywhere. That is moving across. So today, I think that is not taking the front seat, which used to be that people really want to have a touch and a feel that is important. It is important, but that's not very urgent today. To that, the urgent need is who is fulfilling my demand, because I am ready to shell that particular money out. I have my way about to do it. Who is trying to do and who is trying to make that most out of it?
Now, you mentioned about geographically, if we look at the entire India, what are some of the triggers that has created higher demand across different regions? If you can give example, how's the northern region or the western region?
I think that would be difficult to say today because still everybody is recovering more from the entire particular lockdowns and semi-lockdowns and district lockdowns and state lockdowns. I think the demand has been everywhere, and it's also a reason because of the pent-up demand which was there to not be fulfilled for a couple of months. But I think unilaterally, the demand is there across India, across the entire spectrum. And if I take a data which was published, I think by Flipkart or somebody else, it was Flipkart that actually published a data after the 6th or the 7th August ka sale which was actually happened. 50% of their particular orders has come primarily from non-metros. 50%. I'll just, I think it is 50%. I will Just check in whether it is 50%. What I remember to the best, it is 50%. Whether entire so idea is that demand is there and it is coming across the spectrum that you actually talk about. It's only thing that are you as a brand, are we every particular brand is able to fulfill that demand? I think that's a bigger and a larger question today.
Okay, so I have two questions. One is, what percentage of your sales is coming from non-metros? If you can give a number on that, and how do you see in this share increasing going ahead? And how important is non-metros in your marketing mix? And how are you putting it together in your overall marketing plan?
See, so first question I can't answer because we're in a quiet period. So I can't tell you any figure. We are just because we're a listed company, we'll just be having results to announce. Second question is, see, non-metros is a very significant part of the entire mix to look for. And if you talk about from the overall balance, they are the heart of any particular marketing campaign that we do in Havells today. And it is very, very important because apart from growth and also it's also give you a larger brand promise and also larger brand acceptance in those particular markets. What happens to those particular brands and acceptances? Your reach increases. You also have to increase your particular consumer base because these are the people who are ready to experiment with your particular product and categories. So if you ask me, they are very important. They are the heart of our particular marketing proposition, which is very, very dear and very, very closer to us.
The festive and the wedding season is, it has already started. So, what is the demand that you're anticipating, particularly from the non-metros?
I think demand, what we look for it, I think it will be very, very good. Definitely it will be a good demand. Also, if you see, still we may talk about India still is 63%. It's an agri-based economy, which is there. It has been a good agriculture season. The monsoon has been very, very good. So the demand would be very, very good. Also, what has happened is this time the festival also starts a little late in the year. So even the impact of the COVID will also be a little dried down by that point of time. Plus, also your impact would be much more higher for people to have a chance and people have a reason and occasion to buy. Definitely, quite hopeful in terms of the demand would be very, very good.
Have you noticed any particular consumer behavior change in these 6 months that you see are going to stay permanent going forward also?
I think first thing is physical contact and physical visit. In terms of buying any particular product, would definitely be a big change in the consumer demand. Because today, everything is happening at the click of the button. And you just have to be with your mobile, and that's your biggest companion together for today for everything. It is for your entertainment, for any needs that you have, for your basic calling needs, for your ordering a product. So I think this will definitely stay for quite long. Also, I think the quotient of hygiene that has actually increased in India was not there. And I think you'll agree with me in terms of the way people are cautious today in terms of their own health, cautious in terms of their own hygiene factors today, which is definitely even today there are a lot of conversations which we listen on social listening and people talk about what are the basic cleaning needs that you do when the product is arrived, what are the cleaning needs that you actually focus when the product is looking for. I think that is definitely going to stay. Also, one thing which is very important is the dependency on going to the market, dependency only on depending on certain particular whereabouts, even in any particular, whether it's metro, non-metro, whether it is a satellite market or it's a satellite town, will not be there anymore. So you will not be dependent on a larger market today because today the power and the shift of consumer of movement of buying is in consumer hands because all these platforms, their deep-rooted penetrations are actually moved. This is definitely going to stay because this has become a practice and part of your life. And what happens is it's always saying that once your habit is spoiled, you always want to keep that spoiled habit for life to move across. And I think that's a good habit to actually move because that will make a huge difference in the way you really want to look the entire movement of your habits that are moving.
Yeah, what do you think would be the key drivers of growth for the consumer durables category going forward?
I think the biggest driver of growth I would look for is the amount of agility that you can bring in terms of as per the consumer needs. How are you actually trying to adapt and how are you trying to readapt and recircle yourself and as fast you can actually reach out to consumer for their particular needs. Second thing is, which is also most important is how much you are accessible and how much is your accessibility can actually bring in the entire ecosystem. Are you able to reach to the point that your consumer need to look for in this entire omni-channel world, are you able to get every ducks and every particular touch point where consumer look for it, that's all. Third thing, which is also most important, is are you able to make it affordable? That will actually trigger today, because it is not, again, I'll repeat it, its affordability is not by reduction of price or lower the price. It is about what is the value that I'm actually creating and what is the value that I'm trying to build with the same money that I'm trying to shell out. I don't have a problem of shelling out the money, but I have the problem of, do I really believe on the features and the product that I'm trying to build me is a real justification for the value for the money? And lastly, it is all about authenticity. Because what happens is, and you must be hearing about, Pali, a lot of people talk about that the product which I got from any of the platforms was a fake or a first copy and all. So authenticity becomes, what happens if the authenticity breaks down, that entire trust of the entire trust that actually goes in a big, big, big fashion. And apart from the anything that will also circle, there's also very simple framework which most of the people follow today, which is also a 3T framework, which actually talks about trust, transparency, and technology. So are you able to build the technology so that everybody has an access on their particular hand, and it's a glitch-free technology, because internet is already reached, and today the discussion of infrastructure internet is gone. You don't need laptops and you don't want to invest because mobile is the biggest revolutionary tool that you have. Second thing is, are you able to transparently deal the confidence that you want to do? Is there still people are hesitant in terms of doing an online payment and transaction? That is what we need to build from a infrastructure pro. And the then the largest and the last and the largest point and the most important point is, are you able to build that trust? Because these are all volumetric products. People doesn't want to, it is not about 2,000, 1,000, 5,000 to invest. They're volumetric products. If you're able to build all the three, I think the sky will be even less for you as to limit and to get your particular limit there.
Just last question. You mentioned reach is also very important across for non-metros. What is one of the key challenges that you face in terms of reaching out to all these metros?
I don't think so. See, reaching out is a challenge today, because today you can reach out to different means. You don't have to be only with a physical store to be. You can reach out to different. The idea is you really need to map the markets according to their requirement, rather mapping the market according to what you can offer and fulfill. That's a bigger challenge. What happens is, mostly people decide their particular strategies without keeping in mind what is the need of that individual market. And every market, India is not about only one market. India is a 26 different markets, and you have to have a different approach. So one size, one market approach doesn't fit for all. One size will not have a replication on the other. The only thing that you can do, you can take learnings, but that learning will not be that much effective. What you need to do, you have to craft a different approach, different marketing proposition for every market that you really want to cater and really want to capture.
Great. That's an amazing insight. Thank you so much for sharing your views on this entire non-market or non-metro market. Thank you
Thank you so much,
for
Paolo. Thank you so much.
it
Thanks for
was a
being
pleasure.
patient with me. And thanks, Imran. Thanks for joining me. Thank you so much. Bye. Take care.